Hi students, in this video class I am going to teach you about the string handling, how strings used in Java. String is an inbuilt class present in lang package. String class works like a data type. If it is a class, it means it contains many functions, and functions can be either static or non-static. Almost functions in the string class is non-static. Before starting the function, you must know how to create the string class object, how to assign the values. So see here, string is a class, string. If object name is st equal to new string. This way we can create the object by providing the name st. Now how will you supply the values? This is the constructor part. Value you can supply st equal to the word is suppose computer. After creating the object we can initialize it like this. Or another way, you can also make use of the constructor. This is the constructor. Here we can also supply the value. So st will be initialized with the word computer. In very simplest way, without allocating the memory using new keyword, you can directly initialize string st equal to computer. So these are the different methods through which you can initialize the string. Once the string is initialized, now you can call the functions. So first thing is you can also concatenate strings. Concatenate means joining the strings, joining one or more string. The process is called concatenation. If we have one string variable a equal to the word is computer and another variable b is having the word is machine. I am taking third variable string c equal to a plus b. So c is a string variable which contains the value, both the value will be joined and it will become a one word, that will be computer machine. So output will be here computer machine. This is called concatenation. Using plus operator you can join the strings. Now if you want to join some more strings like the word is software, so this is the string constant, this can be joined with this word. Afterwards if you want to join the join some numeric values, suppose 5 plus 6, then how it will be joined? Computer machine 5 and 6. Software word is also here. If we are joining the software word, first of all software, then 5 6 5 6 will be concatenate. It will not add and concatenate. But if you use brackets here, then first it will be added, then it will be joined. So it will become this statement, computer machine software 11. So this way we can concatenate the strings. But Java provides one function, concat function, to join the strings. C equal to a dot concat b. call with the first string class object a dot concat, passing second object as a parameter. So it means a plus b. Even if you want to join some more string constants or variables, you can use a dot concat b dot concat d or any other string constants you can join here. So this is the function provided by the string class. Next function is length. Length function is used to count the number of characters present in the string. If we have one string like this or this way, anyway, suppose we have one word computer stored in a variable as t, then you can use length function like this, n equal to st dot length. Number of characters are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So when you print the value of n, it will print 8. If a string contains spaces, any special characters, that will also be counted. Next function is toUpperCase. toUpperCase function will convert all the characters present in the string into capital letters if it contains some small letters, but other characters may be special or digits if present in the string constant, then this will not be changed, that will remain same. So if we have one word computer and you are using the function string b equal to st dot to uppercase, then all the characters present in the string will be converted into capital letters, all the small letters, rest of the characters will remain same. Same function is toLowerCase. It will convert all the characters into small letters. So next function is charAt. If we have a string variable st equal to the word is computer, each character in the string is having one unique index. The index of first character is 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So 0 to 7 is the index of each and every character this way. So now charAt function will provide you a single character. I am writing char k equal to st dot charAt 3. So we can extract only one character from the string at the specified index. Index is 3. So at 3, index p character is there. So you can print and check the value of k. It will print p, this character which is present at index 3. Index of function, the opposite of this function charAt. Index of function will return integer value, integer value of the character specified in the parameter. Int n equal to st dot index of p, you can pass character. So p is present here, only the first occurrence of the p. If this string contains more than p here, but it will give you the index of first occurrence of p. You can print and check the value of n, it will be 3. If the word also contains computers p like this at index 8 and 9, so there are two p's, one is at index 3, another is at index 9. So but it will return the occurrence of the first character, this one. If you pass two parameters like comma 5, in this case index of function starts searching the this character P from index number 5. So 5 onwards P is here, index is 9. This time it will print 9. Similar type of function is index of, last index of, last index of P. It starts the searching from right side, right to left. So P is present at index 9. So 9 will be the value of n. Same process, you can also pass two parameters 5. Then 5 onwards, onwards means this side, from 5 to 0, next occurrence of P is at index 3. Let's continue with the next function. Index and last index of, next is substring. Substring function returns a part of the string. We have the word computer SP. If I write string B equal to ST dot substring 3, 5. So 3, 5, 3, 4, only two characters it will return, one character less than 6. If you write 6 here, then it will return 3 characters. Substring of 3 characters start from 3, PUT. So one less from the last index, it will return 3rd character, 4th character and 5th character. You can also use substring function in this way, ST dot substring only 3, then 3rd character's index is P, from here onward the rest of the string up to end. So PUTERSP, you can print and check the value of B. So from P to end of the string. So substring function is a two types, one you can pass two parameters, another is single parameter. Next function is replace. It also returns string B equal to ST dot replace. If I write P comma X, then all the occurrence of the character P will be replaced by the character X. There are two P's, so when you print the value of B, it will print COMX, UTERSX. In place of P, X will be printed. This is the use of replace function. Next function is startsWith. StartsWith function returns Boolean type value, either true or false. If string starts with the particular characters, one or more than characters, then it will return true, otherwise false. I am taking Boolean variable, Boolean k equal to st dot starts with, if I write com. So string is started with the word com, so value of k will be true, it will print true. If it is not start with the word com, it will return false. Same type of function is endsWith, st dot endsWith. In endsWith, if I pass sp, it will also return Boolean value, true or false. String is ended with the word sp, it is true. So value of k will be true. If you write ps, then it will return false. Next function is trim. stream function removes the extra spaces from both the ends of the string, not in from the middle of the string, if the spaces are present in the middle. Suppose one string st equal to some spaces, I am highlighting the spaces this, the word is computer space machine. This is one string constant having spaces at the end and before this string. If we have to remove this, use the function st dot trim. It will remove the spaces from the beginning and from the end. You can print and check. It was trim function. Next function is value of. Value of function converts any numeric value to the string. It is the static function. If we have one numeric value int n equal to 56 and you can use like this, string b equal to string dot value of n. So this numeric n will be converted into a string variable. This is the only static function here. Now next function is equals. We have string is, string class provides as four comparison functions: equals, equals ignore case, and compare to. If we have two string a equal to, the word is Aman, string b equal to, the word is Deepak. Now we have to compare. Equals function can be used here, and equals function returns boolean type value, either true or false. If I take boolean k equal to a dot equals b, so both the strings are not equal, so value of k will be false. If both the word are same, if it is Aman and the value of b is also the word Aman, then value of k will become true. You can print and check, or you can use in this way also. Comparison can be checked directly. If a dot equals b, print same, else system dot out dot print different. A dot equals b returns true or false. So value of this bracket will be either true or false. If it is true, then it will print same. If it is false, it will print different. But if the word is Aman, some characters are in small letters, then it will return false. It is a case sensitive function. Capital will be checked with capital, small will be checked with the small. In this case, it will print different. So if you want to compare and want to check whether they are equal or not, one more function is there, equals ignore case, equals ignore case b. A dot equals ignore case b, it means it will ignore the case sensitivity, because both the strings are not same. It contains capital, it contains small, but it will return true in this case. So this function ignore the case whether it is capital or small. Let's continue with the compare to function. If one string is Aman and another string is Deepak, we can also compare the string with the help of compare to function, a dot compare to b. compared to function returns integer value, it returns 0 when both the strings are same. If it returns non-zero value, it means there is a difference between the string. Now, how can we find out the difference between the two strings? So, what will be the value of n in this case? ASCII code of A is 65 and D is 68. 65 minus 68 equal to minus 3. When we print the value of n, it will print minus 3. So, one more example, if string is like this, Amit Kumar. Now, what will the value of n? First characters are same, both the ASCII code is same. Second characters also same. The difference of third character A and I, what are the difference between the ASCII code of A and ASCII code of I? That difference will be returned by the compare to function. You can print and check the difference. If both the strings are same, both the words are same, then it will return 0. It means strings are equal. We can also use function like this, if A dot compare to B equal to 0. Can print same, else system dot 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 print different. If first string is Aman, all the characters are capital, and second string is having some small characters, then it will return non-zero value, the difference of capital M and small m. In this case, we can also use compare to ignore case function. Compare to ignore case B equal to 0. So, in this case, it will print same. So, compare to ignore case function is not case sensitive function. It compares both capital and small. So, compare to function is having more advantages over equals and equals ignore case. In compare to function, we can also check whether string is greater or smaller. Greater, it doesn't mean in the case of length, lengthwise greater, alphabetically greater, Z side is greater, A side is small. If string is greater, then ASCII difference will be positive. Means if it is suppose Aman and another is suppose Deepak Vad. ASCII code of A is 65, D is 68. The first string is smaller than this one. We can use greater than sign, less than sign to compare whether the first string is greater than the second string. First string is string object by which the function has to be called, and second object has to be passed. This is second string. We can use this function compare to or compare to ignore case if we have to arrange the list of the names in alphabetical order. That's all. Thank you.